is safe working yoga. If I have forklift capacity 3 times, what is this safe working load? Safe working load. That means I can carry this load on a safety way. It will not fall down and my track will not be tipped over or whatever. Safe working load, they said, if you want to know the safe working load, always subtract 20% of the capacity. 20% of the capacity. If you cut down 20% of the capacity of this track, then you will know the safe working load.
Don't have slow. Slow down. Use the brake. No problem. You drive a little bit and do brake. Adjust the steering wheel. No problem if you don't know how the force going, how the track going. Look for the small tire now. How it is. It's like this or like this, and you can tell. So always we start slow, and also, but the most important is we are operating, taking down, put the gear in neutral for safety. Because maybe if you keep it forward, you take your foot from the brake, it will move forward and crash something. And the same in the, if you keep it in the reverse.
Management. Because if I'm inside the warehouse, I will go out. How can I warn the people coming outside? Beep, 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 beep like this. And they will know there is a forklift inside. But if there is no horn, there is no brake. I am operator responsible. I got responsibility. When you drive a forklift without a brake and you hit someone and you injure him, don't tell me the maintenance they make the brake. No, you are in charge. I catch you. You are hitting him. Why don't you report? Go to the management and say, I will not drive this one because the brake is not good. Please make the horn. You see, part of this training in the company, you get knowledge, you get information, speak to the supervisor. You say, you make for us training for forklift, that is the feedback. Our feedback, the instructor say, horn not good, make the horn good. Brake not good, make the brake good. Gear, whatever, like this. It is not a matter of just...
Make yourself flexible.